Hey everyone, this time on Tim Talks Audio, Studio One's tempo track and how to do meter changes. If you are constructing a song, a great way to add or alter the energy of the song is to have a tempo or meter change at different sections. Setting this up in Studio One is super easy. Here's a quick little song using the MVP loops that I put together. I doubled it over so that it gives us some length, and it sounds like this. Let's say I want to add a little excitement halfway through this loop and add a tempo change. First thing you would do is open the tempo track, which can be done a couple different ways. First, you can point and click on this little clock that when you hover over says open tempo track. Another way you could do it is by assigning a custom hotkey. Studio One doesn't have a default hotkey to open the tempo track, so I went ahead and made one that works for me. Mine is Command Option T. And it'll open and close the tempo track. When you make your own hotkey, make it so that it works for you and it's something easy to remember. Command Option T, tempo. So here it is. As you can see, there's not much happening, but that's because it's just a static tempo at the moment, currently set to 150 BPM. Now, let's say at bar 9, we want to increase the song's tempo to 170 to really go over the top, but it's a good way to show you of what's actually happening. On the tempo track, I'm going to hold down the Option key on Mac or the Alt key on PC, and this gives me a pencil tool, but with some different abilities that the normal pencil tool wouldn't let us do. So at bar 9, let's make our tempo change. Keep in mind, the height of the tempo track reflects the available BPMs for Studio One. The smaller the tempo track, the smaller the resolution. So let's go ahead and increase our resolution. Now let's add our tempo change. You can see with a simple click, it put it to 181 beats per minute. If you need to alter this, you can click and drag. Now let's take a listen to our new transition. And there's our tempo change, but let me show you something cool about using the Option Modifier key that we can't do with the regular pencil tool. At bar 10, we can click and drag and create different step tempo changes. And this is dependent on your quantize amount. So right now I'm set for quarter notes, and every quarter note I'm degrading the tempo all the way down to 72 BPM. So now when we listen, it dramatically slows over time. If you need to remove a tempo change that you made, simply click and hit delete. Your last tempo will then carry out through the rest of your song until the next tempo change. I've brought us back to our original tempo, and now we're going to introduce meter changes. Meter changes don't happen in the tempo track, so we can go ahead and take that away. The place to make meter changes is actually just in your standard timeline bar. Let's say at bar 17, we want to change, go ahead and click to locate to bar 17, then right click and insert time signature. You'll get this dialog box, which allows you to enter any number into the numerator and select one of a few predetermined denominators. Let's go for 6/8 right now. Now you can see on our timeline at bar 17, it changes to 6/8, and this will carry out through the remainder of the song or until your next meter change. You can have as many time signature changes as you want, and you're really only limited by your own creativity. Removing is just as easy as right-clicking on the change and selecting Remove Time Signature. It will revert to the last known time signature and carry that one out. That's all for now. If you found this informative, please like the video or leave a comment. See you next time, and thanks for watching.